So first things first, make sure you're using advanced search features whenever necessary. Here's what that looks like. Once you've made a Google search, or even before you've made a Google search, we're gonna head on over to Settings and select Advanced Search. Here, you're gonna be able to hone in on exactly what it is you are searching for by setting more search parameters. And quick tip, I always use advanced search if I'm filtering by usage rights. So this is really handy if you're working on a presentation or something public facing and you want to ensure you can actually use the results, like any images, with no copyright issues. But this was just a little bonus Google search tip for you. And now that I've gotten your beaks wet, here are the best Google search tips 2022. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodian, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a metric ton of Google content. This video is guaranteed to make your life on Google a little bit easier. So you ready to get back to our list of Google search tips? Then let's go. Something that is super helpful when you're searching in Google is to search for specific words or phrases within a title. And for that, we can use the in title and all in title search parameters. So let's say we want to search for the best hockey team in the world, Go Habs Go. And we want to search for this term in the title. We can just add in title with a colon, and then no spaces. Now our results will have the term Habs in the title, but we can take this one step further. Say we wanna search for Habs Caulfield. Now we're just gonna add all before in title. And now we've got search results that feature both Habs and Caulfield in the title. So now let's say we wanna search for something that has the result in the URL itself. Well, wouldn't you know, we can do that too. So we're gonna use the same trick here, but we're gonna type in URL colon, and then our search term. Again, there are no spaces. Now our results will be only URLs with Habs in them. And then again, we can do this for multiple words or phrases, but we need to type in all before in URL. And now we've got only URLs with these words in our current search results. Next up, you can search for specific file types in Google too. Yes, really. So this works by accessing any publicly available files that are floating around on the web. Just type in the name or title or keywords from a report that you need, hit space, and then type in file type, colon. And then if you put PDF, you're going to get search results with that specific keyword you entered as part of the title. So look at our results here for NHL PDFs. Now the same can be done for other file extensions, like, I don't know, maybe you want an Excel spreadsheet. So just change the file type to XLS, and now our results are only Excel spreadsheets. All right, did you know you can search for related sites and content in Google search? Well, you can, and it's super helpful for researching the competition. All we need to do is type in related, colon, then add in the site or term we want to get like results for. So if I want to gauge for YouTube's competition, here we're only going to get results for related sites. Similarly, we can search for synonyms. This is great for those results you might miss out on if you don't know the exact word or phrase you're looking for. So let's say we want to search for affordable keyboards. We're just going to add a little tilde symbol in front of the word affordable. Now our search results will include results with synonyms to the word affordable. So we've got cheap, budget, and so on. And speaking of being cheap, another really handy Google search tip is to search between numbers. So let's say you're looking for a laptop within a specific price range. Well, Google can help you out with just that. So let's search for laptops between $500. And then we're gonna add three dots and say 1500. Now our search results will only be laptops in that price range. It's pretty handy if you're on a budget and you want to immediately exclude more expensive options. By the way, if you're liking this video so far, go ahead and give it a like and remember to subscribe to my channel for more content like this. And now back to our Google search hacks. Did you know you can really quickly search for a definition in Google too? So all we need to do is type in define, colon, and then the word we want to define. And once again, there are no spaces here. And just like that, Google will give us the definition. And if you do a lot of copy and pasting with images, you're gonna wanna quickly find images with transparent backgrounds. And wouldn't you know, Google can serve you just that. So we're gonna head to Google Image Search, and now we're gonna go to Tools, and then Color, and select Transparent. Now, only those images with transparent backgrounds will appear. Now let's talk about one of my favorite Google search features ever. I've mentioned it before, but it bears repeating. You can actually search Google with an image. So you can either upload an image or paste a URL into Google search for those times when, say, you see a jacket somebody's wearing and you don't know where they got it, or there's a piece of tech gear and you want to know what it is. Well, Google can help you out. So we're gonna head to our Google Images search for this one again. Now from here, click on the camera icon in the search bar, and then you can upload a photo or paste a URL. So I'm gonna upload because I've already snapped a picture of the jacket I like. And so now Google will pull up either the exact image or something closely matching that image. How neat is that? And by the way, you can add keywords to the search up here too if you need to help Google along a little bit. And last, but certainly not least on my list of Google search tips, is to use the asterisk to fill in the blank for you. This is such a good Google search tip if you can't remember the song lyrics, as an example. So using an asterisk in Google search is essentially telling Google to leave that as a placeholder that you need the search engine to fill for you. So using a song lyric as an example, I'm actually gonna use a little quote trick here too, which I've featured in my other Google search tips videos. And what's that Taylor Swift song? Take me to the asterisk where quote. Okay, I don't remember, so now I'll just hit enter, and would you look at that? The top search result, lyrics for Taylor Swift's The Lakes. This trick literally works to fill in the blank for anything you can't remember. And if you want to learn even more Google search tips, like that quotation ones or how to search using custom date ranges, I've linked to my other Google search tips video in the description below. So those are the best Google search tips 2022. What are your favorite Google search tips? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more content like this. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.